Welcome aboard, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Friday night Ranger hoops right here at the Forest Lake High School. You are about to be watching Ranger basketball right here on the one and only Lakes Area Community Television. Hello, good evening. Thanks for tuning in. Thomas Glenn here bringing you game number 17 for... well, the visitors. For your Rangers, this is game number 16. Forest Lake riding a home record of 7-2. This is game number 2 of a two-game series between these two teams. Forest Lake losing by just 1 point back on December 29th, 2016. That one on the road at Cottage Grove. Looking to turn the tables here tonight. 2-5, Cottage Grove. 3-5, Forest Lake. Tip-off just underway here at the Forest Lake High School. It is a very, very foggy Friday, January 20th, here in foggy Forest Lake Town. That one in slow motion, picked up by Moscatelli, basket no good. Rangers on attack. Sophomore Lexi Holtman back out to Stumney. Stumney over to Asperine. Asperine back to Holtman. Holtman loses possession. Here come the Wolfpack. Open for two. And that is her first basket of the night. That is number 3, Riley Perryman. Wolfpack on the board, 2-0. Rangers again lose possession. Wolfpack on the attack, leading by 2 with 57 seconds removed from the first half. It's a nice setup back outside for 3. Bucket no good, but the visitors do grab the rebound for 3. And the visitors firing on all cylinders here in the first 16 seconds of play and take a 5-0 lead over your Forest Lake Rangers. We all know this basketball team is not particularly strong in the beginning phases of the first half. But, you know, that's something that Coach Wagner has wanted to work on with these girls all season long and, you know, gradually getting a little bit better as the season goes on. But they find themselves trailing by 5 here in the first 16 seconds of play in a place where they are 7-2. So Coach Wagner taking a timeout. Just reminding them to slow things down. The game will come to you. Moscatelli over to Holtman. Holtman back to Asperine. Collision mid-court. Violent. Let's hope everybody is all right. It looked like Asperine took the worst of it. Turnover. Rangers back on the attack. Moscatelli looks for options. Finds Asperine over to Stumney. Back to Asperine. Moscatelli thinks about 3. Hands it off to Asperine instead. Now Stumney. Back to Moscatelli. Holtman. Asperine thinks about 3 herself. Takes it inside. Leach for 3. Look good just outside. Burka, number 23, with her first. Forest Lake will maintain possession. Inbound pass to number 40, Abby Leach. Now the sophomore Lexi Holtman on the drive. heavily contested, fouled maybe once or twice in the process. And the officials will say Cottage Grove ball. Forest Lake has definitely stepped up the pressure. However, Cottage Grove able to keep their cool. Maybe a little rushed on that shot there, picked up by Moscatelli. Let's see if the Rangers can get it on the board. Asperine over to Stumney. Forest Lake in the traditional maroon and gold. Cottage Grove wearing the road white here tonight. And again, the Rangers have turned the ball over, putting them right back on defense. Taylor Johnson, number 11 for the Wolfpack. To number 23, Burka. Another three-point shot taken. Basket no good. Second attempt, nope. But they do grab the rebound. That is Burka. Back to Johnson. Haltman all over her. Inside to number 30, layup is good. That is Delaney Young. And the Wolfpack, seven straight points to take a 7-0 lead over your Rangers. Number 5, Abby Asperine. Back to Stumney, over to Haltman. Asperine outside. Moscatelli for 2. Shot is off as well. Rebound going to Cottage Grove. Taylor Johnson. Layup, no good. Rebound picked up by Lexi Haltman. Foul on the visiting Wolfpack. Forest Lake making a couple of substitutions here. Making their debut, number 23, Grace Van Bergeren, as well as number 30, Abigail Gronwig. Gronwig with possession. Back out to Van Bergeren for 3. Shot's no good, but that is carried out of play by Cottage Grove. Forest Lake will hang on to possession. Gronwig has had an impact, an immediate impact in every game she has come in thus far, whether it's been on defense, offense, doesn't matter. And Coach Wagner putting her in, hoping for some sort of spark here early on. Asperine. Rangers officially on the board. Asperine for her 2nd, and that is nothing but net. Rangers with 2 on the board. Checking in for your Rangers, number 24, Allie Bartlett. Looks like Coach Wagner utilizing her bench tonight. Burka to Johnson. Johnson on the drive. Forest Lake needs to watch her number 11, Taylor Johnson. 7-point lead here for the visiting Wolfpack. Bartlett to Leach. And Leach nearly has that pass picked off. Close enough, they're going to say. Wolfpack ball. Inbound pass good. Burka to Johnson. Wolfpack on the attack. And a mental error on the visitors that will cough the ball up to Forest Lake traveling on Cottage Grove. Van Bergeren with possession for Forest Lake. Cross court pass to number 35, Tia Moscatelli. Runs out of real estate. To Leach, Leach to Gronwig inside. Abigail running out of options. puts it up for two, no good. Gets the rebound, possession lost, picked up by Moscatelli. Jump ball avoided. Bartlett with possession, decides to take it herself. Kicks it out to Gronwig, and she is heavily contested in the process. Should see her go to the line for at least two. Gronwig missing her first. Abby Leach to the bench, bringing in number 20, Lindsey Johnson. Gronwig with her second. Second is no good as well. Forest Lake struggling on offense. Like I said, it is no surprise. It is not a drag on this team. We all know how talented and deep this team is. It just, for whatever reason, takes them midway through the first to get really warmed up. Johnson, another layup. That young lady is deadly inside. 9-point lead for the Wolfpack. Bartlett to Johnson. Johnson, layup no good. Rebound grab by number 30, Delaney Young. Hands it off to Taylor Johnson. Johnson defending Johnson. That's Johnson and Johnson. Burka with possession for the Wolfpack. Now Johnson. Cross court pass again, Burka. Back to Johnson. Traveling is the call. Ranger ball. Forest Lake 2, Cottage Grove 11 with 11:12 left to go here in the first half. Let's see if the Rangers can get it turned around. Do not want to wait too long. Asperine out to Johnson. Johnson to Van Bergeren. Van Bergeren, Asperine. Back out to Van Bergeren for two. Bucket no good. Jump ball awarded to the visitors. Or I mean the home team. That's what I meant to say. Again, Forest Lake 7-2 while at home this season thus far. There we go, Abigail Gronwig. Cottage Grove 2-6 while on the road this season. Beautiful, nice steal by Gronwig, and like I said, she's having an impact on this game already. Bartlett, back to Asperine. Asperine with the drive and fouled in the process. For whatever reason, her and Leach seem to get like the worst of the physical play out on the court. Somebody's hitting the floor, I can guarantee you it's either Leach or Asperine. Asperine, good on her first. Haltman checking back in for Forest Lake. Asperine with her second, and that is good as well. Forest Lake 6, Cottage Grove 11. Turnover inside the Wolfpack zone. Asperine wide open. Look at that. Coach for Cottage Grove absolutely disgusted with the breakdown in the defense there. That's going to force a timeout. 10-11 left to go here in the first half. Forest Lake trailing by as many as 9. Have cut the lead down to 3. This is game number 17 for the Wolfpack. Game number 16 for your Rangers after tonight. Forest Lake on a four straight. Rangers are 3-5, 9-6 overall. That's overall. And this is in the Suburban. Yep. That's the way they tend to start out, but they pick it up usually in the later stages of the first half. Or back to action here at the Forest Lake High School. Cottage Grove with possession. And on the move. Burka. Abby Asperine being charged with her first. Burka with possession for Cottage Grove. Over to number 10. Molly Winner. First attempt, no good. Second, no good as well. Bartlett with the rebound. Here come your Rangers, trailing by three. Asperine for two. Off of the board, no good. Rebound, Haltman. Layup. Plenty of English. Still no good. Attempts one through three. Unsuccessful. Cottage Grove back on the attack. Possession lost. Ranger ball. Maya Tanberg making her debut here tonight. Tanberg, a junior for Forest Lake. Asperine thinks about three and is elbowed in the process. You gotta be kidding me. Really? Huh. Interesting. Cottage Grove on the move. Winner for three. And it falls through. Forest Lake back on the attack. Johnson looking to respond. Layup no good. Forest Lake trailing by six, back on defense. Johnson calling the shots for the Wolfpack tonight. Burka. Again for three. Rebound picked up by Forest Lake. Rangers back on the attack. Haltman, now Asperine for three. Plenty of time and space, shot unsuccessful. Kicked back outside. Nice save by Asperine. Bartlett. Asperine for three. And there it is, Ranger Nation. 6-point lead cut down to three. And look at the defense shine. Checking back in for your Rangers, Stumney and Moscatelli. Ball awarded to the Wolfpack. Cottage Grove 11, Forest Lake 14, with 7 minutes 43 seconds left to go here in the first half. That's for two. Basket no good. Rebound picked up by Van Bergeren, and here come your Rangers. Haltman. Asperine open for three. Back to back. And this game is tied at 14. Defensive pressure definitely has increased. Johnson on the drive has already proven to be a valuable asset for Cottage Grove. Moscatelli for two. Tia struggling with accuracy issues here early on in the first half. no doubt that they will come back to her. On the court for your maroon and gold, number 32, Kenzie Stumney, Moscatelli, Van Bergeren, Tanberg, and Haltman. Wolfpack with possession and on the move. Pass stolen by Stumney. Here come the Rangers. Haltman on the drive, and it opens up. Fortunately, the Rangers avoid turning the ball over there. Three-point shot taken by Moscatelli. This is not a diss, but I have to be honest. I am surprised she didn't take the shot. I don't think she was expecting the lane to open like it did. Tied up at 14. Burka. Nice move. Layup unsuccessful, but she will head to the line for two. That is number 30, Delaney Young. That is the first on Moscatelli. And Young misses from the free throw. One more attempt.
Sometimes all it takes to be a dad is remembering how to be a kid again. Take time to be a dad today.
Welcome back to the Forest Lake High School, ladies and gentlemen. Second half just about to get underway here between your Forest Lake Rangers and the visiting Cottage Grove Wolfpack. Forest Lake currently with a record of 3-5 in the Suburban East Conference overall, 9-6. On the other side, 2-5 for Cottage Grove, 6-9 overall. As we start out the second half, your Rangers with a one-point lead. We've got a close one here at the Forest Lake High School. You are, as always, watching Rangers basketball right here on Lakes Area Community Television. We are your official voice of everything Rangers. Wolfpack with possession, trailing by one. This is game two of the two-game series between these two teams. Cottage Grove leading the series 1-0. 46-45 victory back on December 29th of 2016 by the Wolfpack. Back out to Burka. Burka on the drive. Back to Perryman. Outside to number 32, Thur. Perryman with the two, unsuccessful jump ball coming, awarded to looks like the CG is going to hang on to the ball. Burka with possession. Kicked back outside to Wenner. Over to Thur. Back to Young. Young on the drive and just looks like she lost her footing. Shouldn't be a foul or anything on the play. Possession lost. Ranger ball. All right, ladies, let's step it up. Haltman for your Rangers. I asked Brian to stun me. I don't think so, but okay. Traveling is the call. Forest Lake in the traditional maroon and gold. Cottage Grove in the road whites. Burka for the Wolfpack. Inside, that's Leach breaking that up. Ranger turnover. Moscatelli for Forest Lake. Now Stumney. Back out to Haltman. Haltman, just a sophomore. You're going to be hearing that name as well for years to come. Asperheim. Back to Stumney. Unhappy with the play. Asperheim. Calling the shots. Moscatelli looking for something inside. Runs out of real estate. Back out to Stumney. Inside the Leach. A little too high. Turnover. Wolfpack ball. Nice job by Stumney to get a hand on it. Just enough to break up the play. Rangers with possession. Moscatelli no look to Asperheim. Back out to Stumney. Over to Haltman. Haltman, nice spin, layup. Doesn't get much prettier than that. 3-point lead for your Rangers. Wolfpack back on offense. Perryman open for three, did not take the shot. Now to Burka. Trying inside, I don't know what she was trying for. Must have gone off one of the maroon and gold. Cottage Grove will hang on to possession. Young's pass deflected. Haltman out to Leach, open for two. Basket no good, but the rebound by Stumney is Rangers with a 5-point lead. Nice. Ranger ball. And a smile on the face of Coach Wagner. What more can you ask for? Look at this. Wide open. Asperheim through the back door. Rangers 34. Wolfpack 27. They did not see that one coming. ...14-13 left in regulation. Forest Lake beginning to run away with it. Runs out of real estate. Is this a turnover? It's looking more and more like it. Yes, indeedy. Ranger ball. Specifics unwarranted. Haltman with possession. Over to Stumney. Are you flipping kidding me? That was simply to compensate for the messed up call prior to that. It has to be. That was not a traveling. Wolfpack with possession. Trailing by seven. Cross court pass, 2-on-1 break. Layup is good. Haltman with possession for your Rangers. Asperheim on the drive, runs out of room to Moscatelli. Rebound, Haltman. Runs out of room, but she creates it. Beautiful. Forest Lake able to respond immediately. Inside to Young. contested. And Young will head to the line for two. Foul coming on Leach. Leach, that is her first. First one is short. Substitutions in check. Coming in for Forest Lake, number 24, Allie Bartlett, and number 30, Abigail Gronewig. Playmakers in the house. Moscatelli with possession for Forest Lake. Gronewig to Asperheim, open for three. And it is money. 10-point lead for your Rangers, the biggest thus far tonight. Inside pass to Burka. Turned over, Gronewig. Here come the Rangers. Haltman. Basket no good as she is fouled in the process. Haltman to the line for two. Foul on Johnson, and everybody in green clearly upset. We are definitely on the wrong side of the court, Brian. First one by Haltman is good. I am just one comment away from being knifed in the back. Haltman with her second. And that is money as well. Rangers now with a 12-point lead. Wolfpack back on offense. That's what I'm talking about. Timeout taken and forced. With 12:40 remaining here in regulation, it's Forest Lake 41, Cottage Grove 29. No, we have to make sure we get the sponsorships, and I better shut my mouth. Oh, hell no. Not mentioned. Tim is going to love that. Oh, did they? Nothing gets you pumped up like Queen. Take that for what it's worth. Open for three, hesitates, passes it back. Now at a Burka. Looks to go inside, but nice heads up play by Bartlett. That's a Wolfpack turnover, Ranger ball. Lexi Haltman with possession. Gronewig. To Asperheim. What? Where are all these visions of traveling coming from? Young on the drive and just has it stripped out of her hands by number 24, Allie Bartlett. Fouled in the process, I'm assuming. Wolfpack will hang on to possession. Thur with possession for the Wolfpack. Open for three, Perryman, and that's gonna fall through. Cottage Grove 32, Forest Lake 41. Bartlett to Moscatelli. And Bartlett. Mental error, that will I was just thinking ahead of the catch. She was already passing it off before she had fully caught it. Nice turnover by Johnson. Open for three, Lexi Haltman, and she capitalizes. Forest Lake back to a 12-point lead. Touche. And got to give him credit. Nice response by the Wolfpack. Altman on the drive, kicks it back out to Bartlett, hands it off to Moscatelli. Abigail Gronwick back to Tia for three. Rebound, jump ball, awarded to. Beautiful. As well as it should. Possession will stay with your maroon and gold. Checking in for Forest Lake, yet again, number 21, Maya Tanberg. Haltman again for three. Rims out. Wolfpack on the attack for three. No good. I believe that is out on Bartlett. Wolfpack should maintain. Burka. Thur on the drive. Loses possession. Picked up by number 22. Ooh, Gronwig hits the floor hard. And she is all right. Wolfpack will hang on to the ball. Looking inside, finds nothing. Hands it off to number 32, Thur. Inside to Perryman. Back out to Burka. That was a decent looking drive. Haltman calling the shots. Gronwig with possession. Forest Lake with an 8-point lead. 10 minutes remaining here in the second half. Forest Lake 7-2 while at home this year. Looking to improve to 8-2. Haltman inside to Gronwig. Gronwig. Was she fouled in the process? I think so. Hoffman being charged with her first. That's going to send Gronwig to the line for two. First one is money. Number 23, Grace Van Bergeren, checking back in for your Rangers. On the court for your maroon and gold as of now, 24, Bartlett 30, Gronwig 21, Tanberg 23, Van Bergeren 20, Johnson. Trailing by 10, Wolfpack on offense. Delaney Young back out to Thur for three. And that hit the strap. That is officially out of play. Basket no good. Ranger ball. Winner will check back in for the Wolfpack. Rangers on the move. Van Bergeren to Johnson. Johnson. Pass intercepted by Perryman. And Johnson fighting for it back. Goes down in the process. And Berger unable to pick up where Johnson left off. Perryman to Friedel. Allie Bartlett, I believe that is her second. Don't quote me on it, could be first. Actually, I'm starting to think it is her first. Thur for the Wolfpack. Runs out of real estate. Gronewig. What is this nonsense? Sure thing, buddy. Wolfpack will hang on. Despite all my hand gestures to the officiating crew up here from the mezzanine. Perryman fouled in the process. Van Bergeren with her second. Yeah, it's her first too. Perryman to the line for two. First one is good. Asperine checking in for Forest Lake. Johnson checking out. Second one is up, no good. Rebound collected by Gronewig. Abigail to Asperine, Bartlett to Van Bergeren. Van Bergeren to Asperine, Bartlett just chilling. Van Bergeren inside to Gronewig. Asperine open for three. What? Are they missing a footstep when they call traveling? They do know it's three, not two, right? Technically, because then that would be traveling. That was the same thing. But I'm not a zebra. Wolfpack on the attack, trailing by nine. Perryman inside, possession lost by Burka. I didn't see a foul, but foul on Gronewig, that's her second. Burka with possession for the Wolfpack. Thur. Guarded by Asperine. Over to number 10. Wenner. Back out to Perryman, and that is a foul. Come on. And for your information, it's maroon, not red. Wenner for the Wolfpack. There we go, thank you. Thur charged with traveling. Ranger ball. Ooh, heads up. Nice recovery by Asperine. We don't need to be trending in that direction, Ranger Nation. Cannot afford to continue to make these mental errors. Burka for Cottage Grove. Now Thur. Over to Perryman. Back to Wenner. Inside. Layup no good. Forest Lake will collect. Maroon and gold back on the attack. Or I'm sorry, red back on the attack. Gronewig with possession for your Rangers. Cross court pass to Rice for three. Shot no good. Wolfpack back on offense. Thur for three. That's short. Grabbed by Van Bergeren. 6:05 now left to play out. Maddie Rice, Tamberg, Asperheim. A for effort. And, yeah, fouled in the process to the line for two. Checking in for Forest Lake, Moscatelli and Haltman. Checking out Gronewig and Van Bergeren. Second one. Good. That's a backcourt violation, by the way, that the officiating crew just missed. Thor with possession to Perryman. Perryman runs out of real estate. Over to Burka. Young to Thor. Thor on the drive, puts it up for two. Rebound grabbed by Haltman. Rangers back on the attack. Maddie Rice has been dangerous from beyond the arc. 3 for 5. Thus far this evening. Tamberg to Haltman. Back to Rice. Moscatelli. Perryman with her, I want to say first. Rangers will hang on to possession. Maddie Rice with possession for your Rangers. Now Lexi Haltman to Moscatelli. Again, Moscatelli has room inside and she will take full advantage of it. Forest Lake now with a 12-point lead. And an excellent stuff by Moscatelli. I don't believe that was the initial call. I believe it was whistled because it went out of play. An excellent defensive move by Moscatelli. Hoffman over to Thor. Wolfpack running out of time here in the second half. Just 4:22. Pass inside, and that heavily contested. Let's see what the officials will do with this. What is that? Is that a foul for Bow Wow Wow Yippee Yo Yippee Yay? Tamberg checking out. Leach checking in for Forest Lake. Young has just earned herself another one from the free throw. Forest Lake 49, Cottage Grove 38. Second one is up and good as well. Cottage Grove making this a 10-point game. Just over 4 minutes left to go here at the Forest Lake High School. Maddie Rice, plenty of pressure. Timeout taken by Forest Lake. Let the music pump you up. Oh, and my cameraman keeps reminding me to wish you all a very happy Inauguration Day. That is coming from Brian. To all of you at home. What an appropriate song in the background. Coach Wagner just has done an outstanding job with this Ranger basketball program. 4:08 left to go here at the Forest Lake High School. Can Forest Lake win this one and prove to 8-2 on their home court? Forest Lake 3-5 right now in the Suburban East, 9-6 overall. Our visitors from Cottage Grove, 2-5 in conference play and 6-9 overall. Twice as nice. Maddie Rice with the inbound pass. Moscatelli now to Holtman. Back to Rice. Rice to Asperine. Forest Lake can afford to eat as much clock as they wish. Holtman on the drive. English looked good, but rimmed out. Defensive pressure has been stepped up. And on the drive, Burka is fouled. Leach with her second. Burka with two. First one is good. 10-point lead, now down to 9. 9-point lead down to 8. 3:40 left to go. Holtman for your Rangers with possession. To Rice, inside to Moscatelli. Finds herself surrounded by White. Inside to Leach, and she just cannot hang on to it. That's going to give the ball right back to the opposition. Wolfpack trailing by 8 on the road. Thuer runs out of room, kicks it back. Perryman with possession for the Wolfpack. Wenner to Thuer for 3. Oh, and if you could just imagine the words that I want to say right now. 2:52 left to go. 12-point lead here in the second half has been cut down to 5. Holtman for Forest Lake. That is a reach and foul. Rangers will hang on. Perryman with her second. Checking out for Forest Lake, number 40, Abby Leach. So who's checking in? It's got to be Gronewig. Maddie Rice to Holtman. Holtman double teamed, kicked back out to Rice. Holtman thinks about 3, passes it off to Gronewig. Gronewig finds herself suddenly with plenty of space. Goes for the layup. Fouled it. Excuse me, in the process to the line for 2. You would think that this is just the most complicated task in the world. And now the fans are just completely confused, and I do not blame them whatsoever. Gronewig making this a 6-point game. 7. Yes, indeedy. Forest Lake 51, Cottage Grove 44, 2:22 left to go here in regulation. Thuer to Wenner. Burka now with possession for the Wolfpack. They do not have the luxury of time on their side. Foul on number 11, Lexi Holtman. That is her first. First one by Wenner. It is good. Molly Wenner with her second, also good. 7-point lead, now down to 5. This is where things are going to get very interesting. Maddie Rice to Moscatelli, Forest Lake looking to stay spread out as they want to take as much time off the clock as possible. Haltman fouled, despite what 50, 60 some people in front of us say about it. Forest Lake 52, Cottage Grove 46. And Haltman making it a 7-point lead, a 145. Abby Asperheim charged for a foul. I know they said at the beginning of the program that this is sponsorship appreciation night, but I think it is also officiating amateur night. Open tryouts for officials. Anybody... Any of you at home, feel free to come on down to the Forest Lake High School in a black and white shirt, and we'll get you on the court. Despite your knowledge of the game, we'll get you in there. Rangers back on offense. Moving the ball around. Haltman checked. That should be a 2-minute minor for boarding. Forest Lake ball with a 1:35 left to go. Maddie Rice to Moscatelli. Expect a few more fouls and even more timeouts. Haltman with possession. Back out to Moscatelli, and she is hacked in the process. Hoffman checking back in for the visitors. First one by Moscatelli, no good. So now we're just going to listen to the fans. For 3. Forest Lake now with a 3-point lead, just a minute left. Asperheim fouled, or are they just going to give the visitors what they want? Because mommy and daddy are unhappy in the stands. Asperheim to the line for, well, I guess it depends on how many the fans of Cottage Grove will allow us to take. Asperheim good on her first, so she will get a shot at her second. 4-point lead for Forest Lake. Boom. 5-point lead. Coach is doing a little bit of jawing back and forth. This is my plea. Please, please, please do not have us broadcast behind the visiting fans anymore. I am in fear of my life. I'm scared to walk out to my car after the game. I don't think I'll ever see our cameraman again. But hey, whatever we can do to get you that shot, we're going to do it. That's how committed we are here at Lakes Area Community Television. We're out in the field putting our lives at risk for your viewing pleasure. We're not complaining. Hey, that's what we live for here at LATV. 59.8 left to go here at the Forest Lake High School. Rangers clinging to a 5-point lead. They have led by as many as 12 in the second half. Fresh out of the timeout. Wolfpack with possession. Thuer to Burka for three. That's short. Rebound by Young, and that travels around the world once but will not fall through. Foul on Rice. And as far as I know, that is Maddie's first. Delaney with her first at the free throw. Second is up. Good as well. Just 3 points separate these two teams. Holtman, oh, come on. I'd say that's a little extreme, considering the fact that all you need to do is, what, poke him with your finger, touch him, and you got yourself a foul. But no, let's feel the need to slam him into the floor. First one by Halton, good. Second one, good. Rangers 57, Wolfpack 52. Let's go defense. First one is Jello. For those of you that don't know, Jello is good. So. Second one is up. Now it is. Again, a 3-point game. Half a minute left to go. Holtman with possession. Nice moves, kid. Asperine. Looks for a lane. Nearly splits the defenders like Moses did the Red Sea. Or something like that. Told you, plenty of fouls and even more timeouts. Right here on Lakes Area Community Television. 24.5 seconds remaining, but don't let that fool you. That actually means 1 hour. 43 minutes. Forest Lake, 57. Cottage Grove, 54. 24.5 seconds left in regulation. If it makes you feel any better, your Rangers are 7-2 while on this court this year. The visitors are 2-6 on the road. Statistically, we will win. And the first one by Asperheim is good. Abby with her second. And that one is money as well. Let's see what the Wolfpack does here with 20 seconds. Eat up the clock. Asperheim with her third, fourth. Delaney Young unable to connect with her first. Second is good. Gronewig, let's play keep away. Abigail fouled with exactly 10 seconds. 4-point difference. First by Gronewig is good. 5-point lead for Forest Lake. Can she make this a two-possession game? And she does. 6-point lead for your Rangers. 10 seconds left to go. Let's go, Rangers. And for three, like it matters, it doesn't. That is a beautiful, beautiful thing. How I love it. After two played, Forest Lake 61, Cottage Grove 55. Forest Lake will improve to 4-5 in conference play, 10-6 overall. Cottage Grove will fall to 2-6 in conference, 6-10 overall. Rangers now 8-2. While at home this season. Forest Lake is off four straight road games after tonight, so they won't be back for a few days, but we certainly appreciate you tuning in. This has been a production of Rangers Basketball right here on the one and only Lakes Area Community Television. Thanks for watching.